Well, here in the deep south, we are not strangers to severe thunderstorm and tornado warnings. In fact, we actually have had several that were issued last night. So to wrap up Severe Weather Awareness Week, our very own meteorologist Alex Puckett had the chance to go visit the National Weather Service in Jackson to see how these warnings are issued. There are many steps that go into issuing a severe thunderstorm or tornado warning. The National Weather Service looks at many radar variables, including reflectivity, velocity, and correlation coefficient. They use all of this information to determine if a thunderstorm meets severe criteria.
All right, so we're looking at a storm that's moving out of Webster County into Clay County here. This is from a previous event, and so right now I have to decide whether or not I want to issue a warning, what kind of warning, things like that. So looks like there's some rotation there, but certainly enough that would probably warrant a tornado warning, especially considering what the storm looks like structurally.
Once it is determined that a storm meets those criteria, it's time to draw the warning box.
So I'm going to drag this little dot here towards where we are concerned about a tornado developing.
After the warning box is drawn, the specifics of the warning must then be determined.
We not only have strong indication on radar of good rotation, we have indication of tornado debris. So at this point, we're going to issue a confirmed tornado warning.
After that, the warning just needs to be sent out to the public.
So now, it's as simple as hitting enter, adding our name, and then that is how the National Weather Service issues warnings in our area so that you can stay safe.
With this week's WCBI WeatherWorks, I'm meteorologist Amanda Reynolds.